I'll try butterbeer for the first time in my life. It's so good. Hey everyone, welcome back. Today's vlog will be Universal Studios. Last Christmas we went to Islands of Adventure. Now we're going to Universal Studios because if you know, it's separated into two parks. The last time we did one, now we're gonna do the other, so it's really different. They both have the Harry Potter world. It's based on a lot of movies and the rides too. So my outfit for today is this t-shirt that has this logo, beige cargo pants, and my Air Forces. I just got in Universal Studios. And we're gonna start this day with a big ride, the Rip Ride Rocket. Last time I went, it was my favorite. It goes up like 90 degrees and it goes down 90 degrees, which is awesome. It's so high up, so fast. I'm still tired, so that will probably wake me up. To Universal Studios in a couple of years because last time we were on the other side of the park, Islands of Adventure, and this park has not changed much since the last time we went. There's one new ride we're gonna do after. I had to tie my hair up because the wind is really strong, and after that big ride my hair was all over the place, so a ponytail is the way to go for today. And now we're gonna do the Fast and Furious Supercharged. It's the new ride here. I've never tried it. Since the last time I went, it was not there. It's only a 10-minute wait, which is so cool. I saw a movie of Fast and Furious. I didn't understand anything of it. It was like the number 9. I saw the number 9 before any other movie of Fast and Furious. Kind of obvious I didn't understand anything since I don't know the storyline of it. But the ride looks so cool. No way, that's so nice. It's like a car garage. I'll try butterbeer for the first time in my life. It's so good. Oh wow. It's really good. It's whipped cream on top. And it's kind of like apple cider and soda mixed together. It's so, so good. I'm at Mel's Drive-In for lunch. It's a retro vintage restaurant. And on the menu there was two vegan options, the Beyond Burger and a fake chicken sandwich. So I took the sandwich. I'm gonna do a review. And the view is so pretty on this, like outside. There's vintage cars. And the whole inside is like 50s based. A lot of pop colors and metallic accents. So yeah, I really wanted to try this restaurant because there was a lot of neon and cool vibes, also vegan options, so it's great for me. My parents are getting the food, so I'm waiting for them, but this is what the decor looks like. It's really cool. There's a lot of neon signs on the windows too. We just did the ride Men in Black, and after the ride my head hurts. So I'm gonna take a little break from all of the big rides, eat, relax, take pictures, vlog, and yeah. This is my vegan sandwich with vegan cheese. If you're not a vegan and you don't trust me, well, too bad for you. But if you're a vegan, then you must believe that this is vegan cheese. And fries, it looks so good. There was a parade that I just saw. It's so cool. There was a bunch of characters like Minions, Dora, Secret Life of Pets, SpongeBob. Now I'm in an alley where there's like a lot of theming around the New York City neighborhoods when it's all vintage. And like, look at there, it's actual buildings with props to make it appear like it's real shops or real areas that work, just like you're in New York City, but in the 50s, 60s, it's so cool. And I took a coffee, well, a nitro cold brew, in a San Francisco pastry and coffee shop. It's so immersive, adorable. And yeah, we took pictures in an alley. They turned out great because it's really different from another land. Like there's like a kids land, Simpsons land, a Transformers area. But I think this is my favorite neighborhood of Universal Studios. Even the streets are not even. Like they're kind of down, which is really like, for example, Old Port Montreal. The streets kind of look the same. It's not flat, it's kind of curved. So yeah, we see all the little shops and places that are usually like desks or storage areas, but they decorate it so it really blends in the rest of the park. Here at Universal Studios right now, the period from February to April is Mardi Gras. So there's a lot of food themed to this event, and I will try this marshmallow pie. And it's like a bunch of chocolate, thanks. And beignets. I've never tried beignets, like real ones. They look so, so good. So yeah, I'm gonna do a little taste test. It's really good, it's hollow inside. There's a lot of powdered sugar. I love powdered sugar. 10 out of 10, I recommend. The marshmallow pie is very good. It's like a whippet, if you know what I mean. It's like two chocolate chip cookies covered in chocolate with marshmallow between these two and colorful sprinkles. Later on, we're gonna do the Jimmy Fallon ride. It's one of my favorites, definitely, because I love the Tonight Show with Jimmy Fallon. I like to watch that on YouTube, so this ride is really funny because he's like a great humorist, for real. And there's a shop or ride next to it that we never did before, so I'm curious to see what it is. And before we did the James Bourne show, like the Bourne Stuntacular, so it's a stunter that does acrobatics and stunts according to the movie. It was so good to watch. It's so like extraordinary because not a lot of people can do stunts like that. And they were like in fake battles. There was fire, water, a little movie and stunts. We're having dinner at this cute Italian place. It's called Louise, and I like the feeling of it. It's nice, they have a lot of seating. I'm kind of getting tired, and tomorrow's plan is really to chill at the hotel, maybe do some shopping. So thank you for watching my vlog. I will enjoy the rest of my night. And yeah, subscribe down below, follow me on Instagram to see some of my posts on vacation. Stay tuned for my other vlogs coming. Bye.